Good morning, Venerable Kelsang. Good morning, Elise. Hi, Hemant. Hey, Alex.
Morning.
Good morning, Anthony. Good morning, Venerable Tenzin Lamo. Hola, Carolina.
Hola, ¿cómo está?
¿Y su amigo?
Gerardo.
Hoy está Alejandra. ¿Hay traducción? Sí.
Good morning, Robbie. Is she Gellicus here?
Please have a seat. Oh, yeah, good morning. Yeah, alhamdulillah.
Start with the Shakyamuni Buddhist mantra three times. Teyata. Te ata omne mane mahamunaye soha. Te ata omne mane mahamunaye soha. And now the verse of praise and mantra for a medicine Buddha. Bhagawan with equal compassion for all, whose name when merely heard dispels the suffering of the lower realms, dispelled of disease and the three poisons, I prostrate to medicine Buddha, lapis light. So let's say this seven times. Teyata om bekanze bekanze maha bekanze bekanze raja samugate soha Teata om bekanze bekanze maha bekanze bekanze raza samgat soha Teata om bekanze bekanze maha bekanze bekanze raza samgat soha Teata om bekanze bekanze maha bekanze bekanze raza samgat soha Teata om bekanze maha bekanze bekanze raza samgat soha Teata om bekanze bekanze maha bekanze bekanze raza samgat soha Teata om bekanze bekanze Maha bekanze bekanze raza samgat soha. Next, the four measurables. May all
so, please think about that if you already generated bodhicitta. If you already generated bodhicitta, so then think when you, when we like meditate on four immeasurable practice by reciting four immeasurable prayers. So then think about if you already generated bodhicitta, that bodhicitta will increase. Not just that, and then also any obstacles. In order to practice bodhicitta successfully, if there are any obstacles, that should be completely removed by practicing for immeasurable. Then the for immeasurable practice itself is like unique method to increase your bodhicitta, okay? Think about that, all like bodhicitta means altruistic attitude, so wish to benefit other sentient beings. Okay.
May all sentient beings have happiness. May all sentient beings be free from suffering and the causes of suffering. May all sentient beings be inseparable from the happiness that is free from suffering. May all sentient beings abide in equanimity, free from attachment for friends or hatred for enemies. May all sentient beings have happiness. May all sentient beings be free from suffering and the causes of suffering. May all sentient beings be inseparable from the free from suffering. May all sentient beings abide in equanimity, free from attachment for friends, hatred for enemies. May all sentient beings have happiness and the causes of happiness. May all sentient beings be free from suffering and the causes of suffering. Be inseparable from the happiness that is free from suffering. May all sentient beings abide in equanimity, free from attachment for friends or hatred for enemies.
Very good. Okay, so now Tuesday is His Holiness' birthday. So His Holiness, I think, personally requested to recite Mani Mantra for his long life. Actually requested each Tibetan person should recite 1,000 Mani Mantra for His Holiness' birthday. So probably giving us opportunity to create merit, that's all. So if His Holiness' personal request to recite the Mani Mantra to benefit us. So if we, because people who love His Holiness' Dalai Lama, so they want to celebrate his birthday, so then so His Holiness taking this opportunity to request people to recite Mani Mantra. So as I said many times before, reciting Mani Mantra, the benefit of reciting Mani Mantra is kind of mind-blowing. So let's say like it rains like 360 days out of 1 year. So every water that's created by rain, you can count that water drop by drop. But reciting Mani mantra, benefit of reciting mantra is far more greater than that. So you can count. So that means that much merit you create. So that is how we should celebrate His Holiness' birthday, fulfilling His Holiness Dalai Lama's request by reciting Mani mantra. So very fortunate to have this opportunity to recite Mani mantra. So hopefully they will create the cause to be born in JSA pure land. So they continue to receive teachings, you know, from the all the manifestation of Cheresik, you know, including His Holiness the Dalai Lama. So however they manifest in whatever kind of form they manifest to benefit us, so then we create the cause to have opportunity to receive teaching from them, okay? So then also, of course, while we recite the Mani mantras, in order to make that beautiful meditations, think about all the problems that related to pride and arrogance, all the complications in life caused by pride and arrogance, completely purified, then your body become crystal clear. All the problem complications related to jealousy, completely purified. All the complications they're related to the doubt or not having a faith into oneself, not having a faith, not believing that you are fully capable to liberate yourself from cycle of existence, not having a faith into that, not having a faith. Not just that, not having a faith, liberating yourself from samsara, not just that, also helping others to liberate from samsara, not having a faith in yourself, not having a faith in teaching, not having a faith in practice, all this, you know, completely purified. So then all the complications that related to the ignorance, fundamental ignorance, completely purified. All the complication of problems that related to the anger, completely purified. All the complication and the problem related to attachment, completely purified by reciting Mani mantra. Okay, so then that is the best way to please one's own Lama. When the Lama is pleased, that will have positive impact on their lifespan. So that's how they live longer life. So the practice is given by Lama, so doing that wholeheartedly with the full devotions, that's the best form of offerings that we can ever make. Okay? Yeah, so now this time is a Mani mantra, very easy to do. So then Lamala will read or chant maybe 7 times, then we'll say 3 malas. So I'm not sure how many people? Just a 3 mala.
So we'll at the end of the 3 malas, we'll chant the last one together. But first 3 and the last one. So first is read the verse of praise. Not veiled by any fault, white in color, whose head a perfect Buddha crowns in light, gazing compassionately at all beings. To you, Chenrezig, all seeing one, I prostrate. So verse 3. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum.
Om Mani.
You know, the green Tara, verse of praise and mantra. We'll say the mantra 7 times. Tara liberates from cyclic existence. Tutare liberates from all fears. Tutare liberates from all sickness. I prostrate to Liberator Mother Tara. Om tare tu tare tu re soha. 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 Now the from the Refuge in Bodhicitta prayer. Let's see, led by Geshe-la.
For the sake of knowledge, this is. It's very like a stanza there. We are Oh, traditionally you recite that before the teaching. So that very stanzas for the sake of knowledge composed by Lama Atisha. Oh, Shakyamuni Buddha's son, I don't remember exactly. So one of them. So when you're, this is like a special Mayana refuge, not just refuge, it's like Mayana refuge, because you are taking refuge in Buddha Dharma Sangha in order to help all mother sentient beings to achieve fully enlightenment. So that's why it's called Mayana Bodhicitta. Mayana Bodhicitta. General refuge that you are mainly focusing on the downside of one's own samsara, So then you're trying to develop this powerful longing to overcome from samsara. So then you see the Buddha Dharma Sangha is the only one who are capable to help you to get out of samsara. So then with that, taking refuge in Buddha Dharma Sangha, this general refuge. And here, the fourth line, this is like Mayana refuge. You are not just reflecting on your own samsara, and you are using your own samsara as an example. So then seeing that in all the beings in the samsara, so then wanting to liberate all of them. So then with that intention, then you take refuge in Maya, Buddha Dharma Sangha, so that then become Mayana refuge. So for the sake of knowledge, it's good to understand. So here, so then you focus, not when you're teaching, but when you do practice, then you focus mainly on your future enlightenment. You focus on that. So then you say this four line, refuge in Bodhicitta prayer. So then after that, then you like imitate, you know, if you know how to set up refuge field. So then the replica of refuge field imitated in your body, so that instantaneously you become Buddha, not just you, all the beings that you are visualizing around you. In reality, if they are dog, they are dog, but for a special reason, they appear as a human form. So then you are leading all of them. You have become like almost a chanting master, then leading all of them to say this refuge in Bodhicitta prayer. Then right after that, replica, you know, Shakyamuni Buddha from the refuge field imitates or dissolves into your body instantaneously. You become, you know, then enlightened being Buddha. Everybody else become Buddha. So it's all happening in your mind. So, but in reality, they are not enlightened. So then after that, then you do full immersion practice. That's how the practice has been done. So then right after that, then you do full immersion practice, okay? So then after when you finish that visualization, so then deep down from your heart, then you make this strong commitment. From now on, I'm going to practice Bodhicitta. And not just that, I'm going to engage myself into the Bodhisattva deed, you know, like six perfections. So then you make strong commitments. So then daily basis, try all your best. So that's how the practice has been done. Sanje jodan zonje jodan la chanju pardon tane jab zonje dagye cheshe jebe sanam je lola penje sanje bola jo sanje jodan choje jodan la chanju dagye cheshe jebe sanam je lola penje sanje bola jo Sadece yazılımda rabdolu şişe devir cücü bu adıda şişe tabi çünkü şişe indiye. Okay. Good morning, Ramasi. Good morning, Anthony. Good morning, Carolina Gomez from Patagonia. Good morning, Arlene. Good morning, Govina. Good morning, Elise. Good morning, Nili. Amaji. Good morning, Susie. Good morning, David. Good morning, Venerable Hamo. Good morning, that is Alexander. Alexandra. Good morning, Borisda Patrick. Good morning, Dr. Watkin. Good morning, Susanna. Good morning, Venerable Kelson. Good morning, Venerable Tintel Hamo. Good morning, Karen. Oh, good morning, children. Good morning, Sarah. Good morning, David. Good morning, Phillips. Good morning, Mary. Good morning, William. Good morning, Panditji, Patti. Good morning, Helen. Aline, good morning. Jessica, oh, yeah. Anybody watching on YouTube, good morning. So, last Sunday, I was explaining the five power. How to combine our spiritual practice into five power. How to combine our practice into spiritual practice into five powers. Well, that's what I'm explaining. Or another way you could say this, like lifelong practice combined, summarized into five power. Okay. So the first one, short review. First one is intention, motivations. So yeah, we do need we need to motivate ourselves. You know, otherwise, many things that our life has been carried out by so many different things. If we don't motivate. Unfortunately, many deceiving thoughts arise, unfortunately. So then we are carried out by those deceiving thoughts. So then our, you know, like, freedom from all the problems from samsara become bottom of the list, because we are carried out by all these different thought. Then not realizing maybe this is the only chance that you got. Maybe this is the only chance you got. So if you are carried out by all these different thoughts, then our spiritual practice become the bottom of the list. So then freedom from samsara also become the bottom of the list. So then all these cycles will be again goes, it's going to go round and round, never stop. now, you know, so then whatever complication come with life, it will continue because same thing, there'll be another life like this and same thing, you know, so moksha will become the bottom of the line, the list. So then carry out all different kind of, you know, like not that important things, you know, carry out by that. So then, so that's why we have to motivate ourselves in order to get maximum benefit out of this precious human life. How to use this precious human life, how to push this boat at least inch by inch every day towards moksha, nirvana. Otherwise, this boat will not move by itself. You have to have motivation. So the power of motivation is very important. Then how to set up motivation? Oh, Lam Rim teaching explains intensively. It's not like a lack of teaching. This is lack of effort. It's not because there's not enough teaching to study. No. That's like Buddha taught 84,000 scriptures. It's not lack of teachings. It's lack of motivations. You know, it's not, oh, we are still here because there's no enough teaching. No, that's not true. No, there's tons of teaching out there. It's lack of motivations. Oh. So now just think. No need to go too far. Just think about yourself. Think about all the goodness that you're enjoying, all the opportunity that you have. Think about them, all the opportunity. Begin with your own life, that somehow you may think, oh, it's not, you know, what you can do as a human, what you can do, what you can learn, what you can think, all those, I say, opportunities. So think about that. So then also focus on the downside, this problem, that problem, family problems, relationship problems, the problem at the job, the problem at the, all kinds of, there's so many different types of problems. Think about that. So then based on that, you precisely calculate how you use your day. Precisely calculate. If liberation and moksha is possible, why we are not starting the process, why not? If liberation is possible, if the full enlightenment is possible, why we are not trying? At least start the journey. There's something we can do. And not able to do that, then probably is a great loss. So that's how you motivate. Oh, this is precious human life. This is maybe the only chance I have. Maybe I should awake. Not just awake, fully awake. Not let yourself carry out all these nonsense things here and there. At least motivate every day. At least think once, every day once, so that I have to do something. If I really care about myself, I should provide myself liberations, moksha, nirvana. That's something I can do. At least motivate every day to become better. Oh, better. Oh, that's motivate. That's how to set up motivations. Because you think about all the opportunity you have, then think of all the downside, all the complications you go through being a part of samsara. So then all the opportunity you have, so then you feel fortunate. you become human, you met teachings, you met pure teachings, you can read, you can study, you can meditate, you can learn. Why not? When? Now, right now. We cannot afford to wait right now. Why? We have no clue. Will you be awake tomorrow? You have no clue. You may think, you have ideas, I have ideas, you have ideas. But that idea is not backed by 100% guarantee. You know, so when? Now, right now. Now. So then life will be, even this life will be happier, better, less stress, more joy, more appreciations, more grateful. Every day feel like you accomplish something in your life. Every day you feel like your life has some meaning, your life is worth to live, because you are excited what you're going to do tomorrow. And you see improvement. So, okay, so at least, I'm asking myself, at least why, if liberation is possible, why you don't start now? Why? What are you waiting for? I don't know what I'm waiting for. Power of motivation. Then of course, meditations, practice, spiritual practice or meditation, whatever you call meditation, spiritual practice, review meditations, analytical meditations, concentration meditations. Then you do meditation. That's called power of, actually it's called power of familiarities. That's what it's called in text. What I see is like power of meditations, power of meditation, power of practice. Oh, there's a second power. Oh. So then third one is called power of white seat. That's what it's called in text. What I see is like actions, power of actions. Now meditate is not good. Now need to manifest in actions. Need to manifest in actions. Power of actions. Oh. Somebody says something, somebody do something, you know, so we are become so sensitive. Every little thing bothers us. So when you remember that you are someone who's very much inspired by bodhicitta, so then these little things become nothing. It's not a big deal. So we just make them very big deal. When you think about bodhicitta, you are someone who's very much inspired by teaching of bodhicitta. So when you think about bodhicitta, these little things here, there, they become nothing. Simjiri Rechi, Namibi, Nana Kapa, Jato Negri, Ninji Michos. Oh. So there we have so much, thinking about bodhicitta give you so much strength, strength, power. Those little things does not bother you at all. You know, so your mind may just make them very big deal. Actually, it's nothing. It's almost like echo. You know, it's almost like echo like that. So the third one, the actions, power of actions. Then fourth one is called number sunjin betob. It's like actually it's power of remedy, power of remedy. Our remedy of anger is patience. That's the example. anger is the most destructive emotions that, you know, we have. Shanti Deva said, you know, Indian master Shanti Deva said, in the guide of Buddhist world, right? Indian master, Shantideva. So in my monastery, the monks, they memorize whole text, root text, that people can say by heart. Oh, Shadantabhi, Dibanes, Shabatabhi, Kadumi. There's no practice like patience, but there's no destructive emotion like anger. There's no practice like patience. Shadantabhi, Dibanes, Shabatabhi, Kadumi. Teve, Suela, Nendezu. Therefore, there's no destructive, even though there's many, many destructive thought. Among those, the worst one is anger. Even though there's many, many practices, but one of the best practice is patience. That's what Shantideva said. I'm just repeating here. Therefore, Sola Nendento, whatever ways that you can practice patience is good for you. It's not just religious business, it's good for you. It's good for your life. Whatever ways that you can practice patience, please do. Shedan Sumu Sem Chana Yini Shiva Nyamin Chus. Chapter number six. Shedan Sumu Sem Chana. If you harbor pain like anger, pain. It's not joy, it's pain. Anger is pain, it's not joy. If you harbor pain like anger, then you are in pain. That is, you are in pain. When you have pain, then that's not good. That's not considered as good life because it's the pain. Not just that you have pain. Now, not just that, you will not experience peace of mind. Peace of mind is gone, completely gone. It came down to zero, gone. No? You are not going to experience peaceful mind. It's gone. There will be no physical comfort. There will be no mental comfort. Not able to sleep. You are not going to have good night's sleep. You are not going to be able to sleep. You completely lose ability to judge. Your ability to judge, you completely lose that because of anger. Because you are in pain. Lose appetite. Lose sleep, lose ability to judge. These are all result of anger. So then focusing on the downside of anger, so then focusing on the benefit of patience, that's how you practice patience. That now you see why it's good for you. It's good for you. So this is just an example, okay? So that's called power of remedy. So then, you know, throughout the day, little things, somebody said this, you know, then this, that. So then, you know, how we lose our peace of mind throughout the day, you know, I know, we all know very well how we lose peace of mind. And we need to learn how to protect that. We need to learn how to make armor, around our mind, make sure that you protect your mind because your mind is very delicate and very sensitive. You need to protect that mind in order to. That's your moral responsibility. Of course, religious Lamrim teach that, but that's your moral responsibility. So that's called power of remedy, such as like the power of remedy. So then last one is power of what you call Alhamdulillah, you remember? When Alhamdulillah, you remember what it's called? Actually it's called power of prayer, Melam Jitobs. It's prayer is kind of wish, you know. Prayer is actually is positive wish. That's what prayer is. It's not that we read. It's like someone positive wish with manifested on piece of paper. We call prayer actually is a wish. It's a positive wish. That's what prayer is, positive wish. From now on, so because now you are so much inspired by bodhicitta, so then you are saying, from now on, may I never be separated from bodhicitta. While I was alive, even like after my death, may I never be separated from bodhicitta, altruistic attitude. Oh, so that's the five powers, okay? Five powers. So then that you can, your practice can be summarized into these five powers. Meaning you wake up, what is the most important? Motivations. In the very beginning of the day, motivation is very important. So then throughout the day, meditations, review, analytical, concentrations, meditations. Then after that, actions. Means like how is integrations. If you try, it makes difference. If you try, it makes difference. There's no doubt. If you try, it makes difference. If you are aware, of the downside of anger, more likely you are not going to get angry. Why we are getting angry? Because we are not being mindful. We are not being mindful. All the problems that causes by anger, we forget. Then we get angry again. Then we regret. Then we feel bad. And then no good. That's the last thing that you need to feel bad. We need something to feel good. So your meditation, your practice, that makes feel you good, feels good. We don't need something to feel bad because life is already complicated. Right from the beginning, right from the birth, life doesn't start with the perfections. It starts with the complications. That complication goes on and on and on and on and on. It's like a roller coaster. Sometimes it's up, sometimes it's down. It's like that. It will never stop by itself unless we do something. So then if you are mindful about the downside of anger, what anger does, so then more likely you are not going to get angry. Then if you are aware of, if you're being mindful, if you are fully aware of the importance of altruistic attitude, bodhicitta, more likely you will be protected to losing your peace of mind throughout the day. Now people say something here, then eventually, before it bothers someone, eventually it's like almost an echo. It doesn't really bother. And maybe eventually it doesn't have any substance, what people say. maybe eventually saying pizza and like, your hair doesn't look good. That's not much different. It's the same thing. Same thing. Because what happened is the truth of the motivation, part of motivation, part of meditation, you are changing your mind, you are changing, you are improving your mind, you are improving your thought, you are improving your thought. There's more positive thought rise than negative thought. Then you are getting closer to liberations. So that's why, then there's, concept is a good life, okay? So five power, power of motivations, power of meditations, power of actions, power of remedy, power of, prayer, the last one, may I never be separated from bodhicitta. Even though when I think about now, bodhicitta itself is so hard to develop, so hard, almost seems like impossible. But I have faith. I have faith in bodhicitta. Even just reviewing the quality of bodhicitta, it helps. So then I very much hope, I have faith in myself, I am capable to develop bodhicitta. So then, it's almost like a new face of moon. First you see a little bit white, it's tough. Then you see a little bit bigger, then it's a little bit bigger, bigger, then and eventually it'll be full like that. In the beginning is hard, you know. Nothing is easy, even making a tea, making a delicious tea, especially like masala tea, Indian tea. You know, you need to learn first. You need to learn how to do. You need to learn from someone who has specialized how to make their tea. So for more likely you'll probably make better one. If you learn someone who don't know how to make tea, probably you are going to not learn anything. So that's why the teacher is important. You know, so so power up. The last one is power of prayer. Okay. So then, yeah. So we will make improve. If Gijigela is making some improve, you can make improve too. There's no difference. If Gijigela is learning something, you can learn the same thing. There's no difference. So just need to motivate. So then, you know, like then throughout the day, you are very happy. Not because you are watching something, or you are going somewhere. No, you are just happy. There's something that you are doing at home makes you happy, makes you very happy. Oh, makes you think that you accomplished something. I can do, you can do, everybody can do, everybody can do. Anything, even the small thing, even learning something new makes you happy. So that when you read something, learn something, it makes you happy. Okay? Every day something. Whether you are reciting mantra, you know, so, or you can like doing lamrim meditations, many, many hours of meditation, that's very good. You know, so review meditation, analytical meditation, then reading something. So then, you know, that's how to make life meaningful, okay? So please don't stall. We cannot afford. This is the only chance we got. We better do something now or start the journey. At least start the journey. If you really care about yourself, you should give to yourself liberation or moksha. At least start the path, okay? So that's also then enjoy the holiday. So however you're going to celebrate, please enjoy. So, and if you can summarize your practice into these five power, so then please remember. Power of motivations. I'm going to repeat one more time. Power of motivations. So the in actual text is called power of familiarities. What I see is like power of meditations. The actual text is called like power of white seat. In my mind, that's power of actions. Then power of remedy, that's the same thing. The text also says in the power of remedy. So then power of prayer. Prayer, that is like, may I never be separated, this kind of wish. May I never be separated from this altruistic attitude. Conventional, ultimate. You know, bodhicitta, when you talk about bodhicitta, there's two of them. Conventional bodhicitta, ultimate bodhicitta. Ultimate bodhicitta is bodhicitta that is supported by wisdom realizing shunyata or emptiness. So that's called ultimate bodhicitta. So conventional bodhicitta mainly generated based on the amount of complication that the being go through, based on that, so then you generate altruistic attitude of bodhicitta, that's called conventional bodhicitta. So then bodhicitta that based on look at that, including myself, nobody, all this being in the samsara, not knowing the ultimate truth, or because of the fundamental confusion or ignorance. So based on that, you develop bodhicitta. That's called ultimate bodhicitta. Actually, that bodhicitta is supported by wisdom, realizing shunyata, or experience of shunyata, then power, bodhicitta, power by experience of shunyata, that's called ultimate bodhicitta. Okay, so then how to develop? Two instructions coming from Shakyamuni Buddha to Manjushri to Nagarjuna to Lama, all the way to Lama Atisha, then coming from Buddha, Shakyamuni Buddha to Maitreya Buddha to Asanga, all the way to Lama Atisha, there's two lineage. Seven causes and one result. That's one coming from Maitreya Buddha to Asanga to Lama Atisha. Then exchanging oneself with the other, that lineage or instruction is coming from Shakyamuni Buddha to Nagarjuna, Nagarjuna to, or Manjushri to Nagarjuna, Nagarjuna. Lama Atisha possess both lineage. So then Lama Tsongkhapa also possess both lineage. So that you can alternate, you know, That's how that's the instructions, how to meditate on bodhicitta. If you wonder, first one is called seven cause and one result. The second one is called exchanging oneself with other. So then how to meditate? Yeah, you just remember the instruction. You just sit down, then you just go through those instructions step by step. Then till you gain some experience, meditative experience. So now, when I say all mother sentient beings, that word has some weight. Before it just word. Now, when I say it has some weight, now I feel something. That's called meditative experience. So that you will gain, not just doing one time, or two times, you gain that doing again, then you gain meditative experience, what is called realization. Next time, when you say bodhicitta, it means this word has some substance rather than just empty word. Okay? Oh yeah, so thank you very much. So thank you, children, for translating people in Patagonia. So then all of you, thank you very much for coming in. So anybody watching on YouTube, thank you. And Arlene the cat. India.
Yeah. Yes, that's Marley.
Marley?
Yes.
Marley, this is the only chance you got to liberate yourself. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Yeah, so dedication.
Yes, shall I make a quick announcement first?
Yeah.
I just want to clarify, because we have announced that next Sunday we are going to begin opening the Gompa for anyone who wants to come in and gather with other members of the center to watch the teachings. It will be on YouTube. Geshe, you will still be teaching on Zoom from home. So this will still be available on Zoom and still on YouTube. But this is just our first tiny step into reopening the center for people to be together with each other while watching the teachings, but it will still be online for most of us, online even when we're in the Gompa. Thank you, Geshe.
Yeah.
So start with the dedication verses from Master Shantideva.
Oh, yeah.
All beings everywhere, plagued by sufferings of body and mind, obtain a notion of happiness and joy by virtue of our merits. May no living creature suffer, commit evil, or ever fall ill. May no one be afraid or belittled, or the mind weighed down by depression. May the blind see forms and the deaf hear sounds. May those whose bodies are worn with toil be restored on finding repose. May the naked find clothing, the hungry find food. May the thirsty find water and delicious drinks. May the poor find wealth. Those weak with sorrow find joy. May the forlorn find hope, constant happiness, and prosperity. May there be timely rains and bountiful harvests. May all medicines be effective and wholesome prayers bear fruit. May all who are sick and ill quickly be freed from their ailments. Whatever diseases there are in the world, may these never occur again. May the frightened cease to be afraid and those bound be freed. May the powerless find power. May people think of benefiting each other. For as long as space remains, for as long as sentient beings remain, until then may I too remain to dispel the miseries of the world. For the long life prayers, in the land encircled by snow mountains, you are the source of all happiness and good, all powerful Chen Reisik Tenzin Gyatso. Please remain until samsara ends. And the next one for Sarah J. Kinsler Rinpoche Jitsun Losandala. The one who mastered his speech at a very young age, the one with great patience who received the name Awatare. The one with great precision who spread the teachings of Lama Tsongkhapa and Bussin Voi, Lama ornament of the Yellow Hat tradition, please remain until samsara ends. And the one for Lama Zompa Rinpoche, you who uphold the subduer's moral way, who serve as the bountiful bearer of all, sustaining, preserving, and spreading Manjana's victorious doctrine, who mercifully accomplish magnificent prayers honoring the three jewels, savior of myself and others, your disciples, please, please live long. And of course, seven green tar mantras for Geshe Gelug and Geshe Sangpo's long, happy, healthy lives. Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Soha. 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 Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Soha.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Geshe-la.
Thank you,
Geshe-la.
Thank you, Geshe-la.
Thank you, Geshe-la.
Thank you, Geshe-la.